Many jobs sound more interesting than they actually are. You can imagine a lot of things you may never do, or that could take years of hard work. An astronaut is not able to go into space without months or years of training. An actor must rehearse their parts for hours and hours before they can perform well on stage. A spy has to watch everyone they meet and always keep their true identity secret. The young singer Suzanne David Hall, protagonist of Kimberly Brubaker Bradley's For Freedom, the story of a French spy, learns this lesson when her hometown is forcibly occupied during the Second World War. The town of Cherbourg, France, is taken over by German forces in the spring of 1940. An initial bombing by German fighter planes comes to break any resistance before the army approaches from the east. Cherbourg surrenders so that it won't be completely destroyed. French citizens are forcibly removed from their homes and given rationed food. They have their identification papers often checked by German troops. The reader sees all this through Suzanne's eyes as she continues to live her life. Suzanne still goes to school and practices to become an opera singer after the occupation, but she is constantly reminded of the German oppression. This forced control can drive people to despair or reckless acts, but Suzanne focuses instead on keeping a strong will against oppression. This eventually draws Suzanne into the French Resistance, a network of spies that seek to help the Allied forces restore France's independence. This book is not entirely focused on the spying, or Suzanne's life during the occupation. It moves between the two areas and sometimes mixes them together. The story is told over a few years of Suzanne's life, so there are jumps forward in time before something new happens. Suzanne narrates events in a non-linear fashion. Suzanne is portrayed as a growing girl who has to adapt to new circumstances, using her wits and connections to remain safe while undercover. She is not a veteran soldier on the front lines of a battle, or the director of multiple spies in some network. She is Number 22, a nameless face who does her tiny parts to liberate her home. Now, the real nature of spying is shown in this book. Coded messages, secret names, and constant travel from one place to another. It is a complex and dangerous life that Suzanne sometimes feels overwhelmed by. What keeps her going is her determination and commitment to her country, even when other spies in her town start to disappear. Readers will feel happy when Suzanne succeeds, and scared when she faces problems. For Freedom has 181 pages, and tells its story without any flashy tricks or climactic battles. It shows how spies worked in wartime and under the face of the enemy. Some readers may not like the realistic narrative or the lack of thrilling moments, and that's fine. Spying is a dangerous job when you really look at it, but that danger is what drives some people to do it. If you think you are willing to read Suzanne's story, For Freedom is available in the middle school library.